So far, you may have encountered assertions in tests, in particular in unit tests. Here, assertions are being used to check the results of a single run, namely the test run. What we're going to look into is assertions that are integrated into the program code itself, where they check all runs at once. A classic example for the use of assertions is a square root program. In the beginning, when invoking square root, we want to make sure that x, the parameter, is non-negative. I'll skip the actual computation of square roots here because this is subject of another class. But before we return the actual square root, we want to make sure that the square root actually is a square root. How do we do that? Well, we square the square root and check whether it's identical to the original argument x. These two kinds of assertions form a pair, and both of them have very specific objective. An assertion that's being called at the beginning of a function and which checks the properties of the arguments is called a precondition. An assertion which checks the result of a computation before it's actually being returned is called a postcondition. If you have such explicit checks in your code, this greatly increases your chances of quickly finding the bug, because these checks would be invoked every single time that the function is executed, and if they don't fail, you know that the computation is actually correct, which is a good thing. If you remember our cause-effect chain as a succession of program states, where a defect introduces an infection which then propagates to become the failure, imagine what happens if you actually do have assertions in your code that check large parts of your state. Now imagine what happens if you do have assertions in your code that check large parts of your state for whether they're valid or not. Suppose you have an assertion that checks all of this area every time a function is invoked. Then you wouldn't see the failure only at the last moment, but you would see the failure as soon as the infection spreads towards it. If you have another assertion that covers this part of the state, then you would see the failure at the very moment it is introduced, which of course also means that you can immediately identify the defect that causes the infection. The earlier you see an infection, for instance because an assertion fails, the shorter the cause-effect chain you need to investigate. Also, if you do have parts of the state that are covered by assertions, and these assertions don't fail, then you know that the state in here is actually not infected, and so in your search, you can narrow down your search towards those parts of the state which are not covered by passing assertions. And all of this happens automatically with every single run, every single test run, and if you want so, even every single production run.